Hello students, today we are going to look about types of beams. A beam is a structural element that primarily resists loads applied laterally to the beam's axis. Its mode of deflection is primarily by bending. The loads applied to the beam result in reaction forces at the beam's support points. The total effect of all the forces acting on the beam is to produce shear forces and bending moments within the beam, that in turn induce internal stresses, strains and deflections of the beam. Beams are characterized by their manner of support, profile, shape of cross-section, length, and their material. A cantilever is a rigid structural element, such as a beam or a plate, anchored at only one end to a, usually vertical, support from which it is protruding. Cantilever beam does not require a support on the opposite side, probably the main reason you would ever have a cantilever beam, and creates a negative bending moment. But cantilever beam show large deflections generally results in larger moments. Simply supported, a beam supported on the ends which are free to rotate and have no moment resistance. A simply supported beam is a type of beam that has pin support at one end and roller support at the other end. Depending on the load applied, it undergoes shearing and bending. It is the one of the simplest structural elements in existence. Overhanging beam. It has two supports, hinged at one end, roller at other end. Overhanging portion at any one of the supports. Loads can be applied on overhanging portion and can be converted to equivalent moment at the support. Moment and reactions are same as that of simply supported beam. Overhanging beam. There are two types of overhanging beams. Middle dot singular overhanging beam, middle dot double overhanging beam, singular overhanging beam, middle dot. It has two supports, hinged at one end, roller at other end. Overhanging portion at any one of the supports. Middle dot loads can be applied on overhanging portion and can be converted to equivalent moment at the support. Middle dot moment and reactions are same as that of simply supported beam. Double overhanging beam. Middle dot. This type of beams will have overhangs at both the support. Both the overhanging beams will have rotation at supports. Fixed beam. A fixed or a built-in beam has both of its ends rigidly fixed so that the slope at the ends remains zero. Such a beam is also called as the incaster beam. The fixed ends give rise to fixing moments there in addition to the reactions. If perfect end fixing can be achieved, built-in beams carry smaller maximum bending moments and have smaller deflections than the corresponding simply supported beams with the same loads applied. Therefore they are stronger and stiffer. However, the need for high accuracy in aligning the supports and fixing the ends during erection increases the cost. Small subsidence of either support or temperature changes can set up large stresses. The end fixings are also normally sensitive to vibrations and fluctuations in bending moment. Continuous beams. Continuous beams are those that rest over three or more supports, thereby having one or more redundant support reactions. A continuous beam is a statically indeterminate multi-span beam on hinged support. The end spans may be cantilever, may be freely supported or fixed supported. At least one of the supports of a continuous beam must be able to develop a reaction along the beam axis. In terms of structural analysis, what we really need is the continuum of stresses and strains. Even though there is a support, the moments are transferred, and by laws of statics, the sum of all the moments, internal and external, must be zero. Thank you for watching. If you want more videos like this, then subscribe Chennai Minds and comment below.